Here, once again, we are starting our indoor and outdoor academies. Last time, we have enjoyed the dance for indoor and cricket for outdoor. So this month, we are going to start for indoor piano activity and for outdoor basketball activity. So for outdoor activities, we have here basketball for you. This month, we will share the videos of basketball. In this first chapter of basketball, we will know about the basketball game. What is the basketball game and what are the rules and regulations of basketball? In this first chapter or first video, we will see the basic of basketball game. This is the team event, and this game is played between the two teams consist of 5 players. Each team is having 5 players. So for this game, we need the equipments like a basketball, ring, net and basketball court. These things are required to play this game with the 5 players. So let's see about basketball. To know more about the basketball game, have a look at this video.
On the morning of December 21, 1891, James Naismith emerged from his office with an idea. He had spent 2 weeks searching for an indoor athletic activity to occupy his physical education class during the cold winter months. Naismith tried indoor adaptations of soccer, lacrosse, and football, but each only led to people getting injured. He was disappointed when he couldn't find an indoor sport. So, Naismith decided to invent it. The first official basketball game was played on January 20, 1892. The contest featured 2 teams of 9 players, and ended in a score of 1-0. It was far from the current version of basketball played worldwide today. For example, basketball was originally played with a soccer ball and peach baskets. So, someone had to climb on a ladder each time to get the ball out. Later, to make it easier, a hole was drilled into the bottom of the basket. The original game had only 13 rules, with no dribble, the 3-point line, and a greater tolerance of physical contact. Still, modern basketball is firmly rooted in many of the original rules.
In this video, you'll learn the basic rules of basketball. Basketball is played on a rectangular court, which is 22 to 28 meters long and 13 to 15 meters wide. At each end of the court, there is a 45 centimeter wide hoop fixed on a panel suspended 3.05 meters above the ground, the basket. 2 teams of 5 players compete over 4 quarters of 10 minutes each. A 15-minute halftime takes place between the second and the third quarter. The objective of both teams is to put the ball through the opponent's hoop to score as many points as possible. A scored shot, called a field goal, is worth 2 points, or 3 if the player has thrown the ball from outside the 3-point arc. The team with the highest score at the end of play wins the game. In case of a tie, the teams play 5-minute rounds in overtime until one team wins. To get the ball across the court, players can only move while dribbling. Or pass the ball, they are only allowed to use their hands. In offense, players can be sanctioned by violation, which leads to a turnover from behind the opponent's baseline. To learn more about it, check out our video on violations. In case of illegal contact, players can be sanctioned by fouls. To learn how not to commit them, watch our video on fouls. fouls are sanctioned by turnovers or free shots for the opponent. Free throws are shot from a line placed near the edge of the key and are worth 1 point. The key, also called free throw lane, is the rectangular area drawn beneath both hoops. At each timeout, the coach may make substitutions. There is no limit to the number of players that can be substituted. Now you know the basic rules of basketball.
It explains the rules of basketball. The object of the game is for your team to score more points than the opposing team. Teams are made up of 15 players, with 5 players on the basketball court at any one time. They consist of 2 forwards, 2 guards, and a center. The game starts with a tip-off. Once someone has won possession of the ball, they have up to 24 seconds to shoot the ball towards the opponent's basket. These baskets are 10 feet above the ground, on a court that's generally about 94 feet long by 50 feet wide, and varies depending on where you play. To move the ball up the court, you can either pass the ball to a teammate, or dribble the ball where you bounce the ball up and down repeatedly whilst in motion. To score points, a player must shoot the ball into the opponent's basket. You get 2 points for any shot scored within this arc. If a player scores from a shot outside this arc, this scores 3 points. Any free throws that are awarded to your team scores 1 point. Failure to shoot the ball within 24 seconds results in a shot clock violation, and the other team is awarded possession of the ball. The opposing team will try and take the ball off you by either blocking shots, rebounding missed shots, or by stealing the ball away from an opposing player so that they can score themselves. The game is played in 4 12-minute quarters in the NBA, 4 10-minute quarters internationally, or 2 20-minute halves in the NCAA, and the highest score at the end of time wins. There are no ties in basketball, so if the scores are tied at the end of regulation, overtime periods will be played to determine the winner. Wow, that was the shortest video ever! Unfortunately, it doesn't stop there. Whilst basketball is an easy game to understand, I've just explained the basic concept of the game. There are a lot of things in basketball that you're not allowed to do. So to make it easy for you to understand, there are generally 2 types of things you can't do: violations and fouls. Violations are generally called when you break one of the rules. The main violations include shot clock violation. As earlier stated, your team has 24 seconds in which to shoot the ball. If you've not shot the ball within this time, a shot clock violation is called and the ball is awarded to the other team. Double dribble. In basketball, you're only allowed to dribble the ball and stop once. If a player then begins to dribble again, this is known as double dribble and the ball is awarded to the other team. Traveling. If a player takes too many steps without dribbling the ball, this is traveling. And surprise, surprise, the ball is awarded to the other team. 3 in the key. A player cannot stay in the key, which is this section of the court, for more than 3 seconds. Charging. A violation in which the attacking player runs into a stationary defender. Possession of the ball is awarded to the defending team. There are other violations that I've included a brief description of here, but the ones I previously mentioned are the ones you're most likely to encounter in a game. Fouls. Fouls are the most complicated thing to understand in basketball, but I'll try to explain this in the easiest way I know how. There are 3 types of fouls: personal fouls, flagrant fouls, and technical fouls. Personal fouls occur when a player commits illegal contact against another player. Imagine 2 players, an attacking player with a ball, and a defending player without the ball. Now imagine 2 giant cylinders that surround them that extend from the floor to the ceiling. Neither of these 2 players is allowed to encroach in each other's cylindrical space. If an attacking player makes contact with a defender in his space, then it's called an offensive foul against the attacker. If a defender makes contact with an attacker in his space, then it's called a defensive foul against the defender. Any foul in the act of shooting results in free throws being awarded to the attacking team. 2 shots for fouls inside the arc, and 3 shots for fouls outside the arc. If the shot went in and the shooter was fouled, the points they scored count, and they are awarded 1 extra shot. Flagrant fouls. Flagrant fouls are severe fouls that occur when a player has made violent contact against another player. This always results in the other team being awarded 2 free throws. Technical foul. Technical fouls are fouls that don't fit the description of either a personal or flagrant foul. Technical fouls can be awarded for fighting, unsportsmanlike conduct, or abuse from players and coaches against referees. 2 technical fouls equals an automatic ejection from the game. Any team that commits 5 or more fouls in any quarter will have 3 throws awarded against them per subsequent foul. And any one player who has racked up 5 fouls internationally or 6 fouls in the NBA, is fouled out and can no longer participate in the rest of the game. This is a lot to take in, especially understanding how the fouls work. But as you watch or play basketball, the rules will become clear.
If you found this, so hope students, you all enjoyed this video and you got the information about the basketball game. So do this practice at home and try to learn the game. This is very good and nice game. So you should also enjoy this game with your friends or with your family. Let's play the basketball and enjoy it. Thank you.